Good day, everyone, and thank you for joining today's webinar. Cold storage providers encounter completely different challenges compared to a non-cooled warehouse, with difficulties such as quality and temperature controls, increasing requirements for product safety, and accurately registering all processes. In today's webinar, we're going to be giving an introduction and an overview of 3PL Dynamics and why the functionality is so helpful for logistics service providers. In addition, we're going to be focusing on the cold storage features, process and workflow configuration, and the integrations which can help improve efficiency even further. There will also be a question and answer session at the end. So please, throughout the whole webinar, ask your questions in the Q&A section, and we'll come to those at the end and we'll provide some more detail. Okay, I will now hand over to Darshan Mangekar, our lead for third-party logistics solutions, working closely with Boltrix on all projects that Mercurius IT is involved with. Thank you, Darshan.
Hey, thank you, Scott. And hello, everyone. So we will start with 3PL Dynamics introduction and then cover rest of the topics which are essential for cold store operation perspective. 3PL Dynamics, which is having a brand standard for logistic industry, software solution designed for logistic industry. So it covers all these vertical or branches for 3PL companies: freight management, transport management, warehouse management, and cold store. 200 plus successful implementations of 3PL Dynamics, cloud or on-premise installation. So both the type of installation it supports. Mobile app platform for warehouse processes and operations. 3PL Dynamics is designed and developed based on the Microsoft Dynamics Business Central, which is a well-known popular ERP platform. These are the other modules of 3PL Dynamics. Finance management, as 3PL Dynamics is designed and developed on based on the Dynamics 365 Business Central, it is seamlessly integrated with its finance module. Customs module for customs bonded goods related transactions. EDI integration for exchanging the messages with the customers. 3PL Dynamics works with its own EDI platform called Data Hub, and there is no dependency for any third-party EDI platform. Customer portal, where customer can log in to the portal and check their status of their own data, for example, inventory statement, invoice details, inbound transaction details, and outbound transaction details. Features for cold store operations. Let's see which are the features of 3PL Dynamics which are specific for the cold store operations. Temperature recording, put away strategies for temperature control zones, catch weight tracking, batch control and expiry date tracking, quality checks at various transaction levels, accurate storage cost calculations, and automatic service charge or value added logistics services to avoid any revenue leakages. Record temperature, pallet temperatures during inbound process. Record pallet temperature during outbound process depending on the customer requirement. So this is a completely configurable in 3PL Dynamics. Automatically add freezing charges based on the recorded temperature. So based on the customer contracts, the way it is configured in 3PL Dynamics, if certain pallet temperature is identified above certain temperature range, then system will automatically add the freezing charges for that specific inbound transaction, and those charges will be invoiced to the customer by end of the invoicing period. So this makes sure there is no revenue leakages and charges are accurately added in the invoices. Let's see a few scenarios in the pallet temperature recording. The first is temperature reading of first pallet from every layer can be copied to subsequent pallets during the scanning process. 3PL Dynamics makes sure that inbound process with the temperature recording will be faster, as well as it assures that there is a quality data of temperature is being captured. So if there are if the pellets are divided in three layers, front, middle, and the back, user will record the temperature of first pellet of every layer, and subsequently 3PL will copy the temperature of first pellet of every layer to the subsequent pellets. For example, in this case, first pellet of first front layer will be copied to the other pellets. First pellet of the second layer, that is a middle layer, will be copied to the subsequent pellets. So this makes sure process becomes faster and quality data is being captured during inbound process. The other scenario could be temperature reading of first pellet is copied till 10th pellet. So in that case, every 11th pellet system would ask to key in the recorded temperature to the user. Third scenario, enter new temperature reading if product code changes. So if the product changes, system will ask to key in the recorded temperature. So these are certain basic three scenarios been highlighted here, from basic to complex one. And there could be a more complex scenario can be configured in 3PL Dynamics. Directed put-away strategies for product-specific temperature control zones. Put-away strategies helps to assign correct location based on the product storage requirements. Tonnage and cubic capacity of the location is also being considered. Warehouse strategy is another very powerful feature in the 3PL Dynamics, which helps to optimize the put-away process in the warehouse operations. These are the three scenarios we have taken here. So in the next slide, we'll see how this scenario works with the warehouse strategy feature of the 3PL Dynamics. First scenario, where red meat is a product. So whenever temperature of the red meat for certain pallets is identified above certain temperature range, 3PL Dynamics will generate the put-away activity to put away those pallets to the blast freezer first, and from the blast freezer, it should go to the zone one, which is maintained at the -5 degrees Celsius. Put-away activities are generated by 3PL Dynamics, which will be visible on mobile app platform. Warehouse user will refer those activities and will move the pallets accordingly to the blast freezer. Scenario two, where product specific dedicated zones. For example, for apples, when the apples are coming in, it should be always put away those pallets to zone two, which is maintained at 10 degrees Celsius. 3PL Dynamics will generate the put away strategies based on the warehouse strategies. And warehouse user will refer those put away activities which is assigned to him, and he will complete the action accordingly. Scenario three, where the customer specific dedicated zones are defined. For example, in this case, this customer always sends the tomatoes for 3PL warehouse, and it should always go to zone three, which is maintained at 12 degrees Celsius. So using warehouse strategy, such a scenarios can be configured, and if there are more complex scenarios can be taken care in the put away operations, which will help to optimize the complete process. Batch and expiry date tracking. Automatic batch number allocation based on the predefined rules. For example, generate the internal batch number similar to the supplier or manufacturer's batch number, or the batch number could be combination of supplier batch number and country of origin. So these kind of business rules can be defined to assign the batch number to the products. Mandatory production and expiry date tracking. Pick strategy based on the expiry date rules. Allocation rules can be defined for a product so that it will always suggest to pick the pallets which are early to expire. Quality checks. Quality checks can be performed during the various transactions, for example, receiving, transfers, or shipments. Incident management, if any abnormality identified, user can generate the incident, that's a request in 3PL Dynamics, which will be assigned to a specific employee to take action on that. 3PL Dynamics also accessible over a tablet device where pictures can be taken and attached to the quality documents. Contracts and invoicing. services and WMS contracts, these two helps to configure complex storage calculations and various service charges. Default service charges, these gets added automatically based on the contract conditions and helps to avoid any revenue leakages. So it completely removes any human error and automatically add the default service charges. For example, freezing charges, handling charges, or any other charges which has to be defaulted on receiving transaction or during the shipment process. For example, empty pallet charges, system will automatically add based on the customer contracts in various transactions. Optional service charges. These are added from the mobile app platform during the transactions. So warehouse user can add the optional service charges when they are performing the business process. For example, relabeling or repacking charges for the pallets can be added by warehouse user manually from the app platform, which will get added in the transaction and system will automatically pick them up during the invoicing period. Service price agreements. Accurate prices are applied based on the volume and other configured contract criteria. For example, prices are defined based on certain quantity slabs. For example, from pallet till 50, the X price above 50 is a Y price is different. Similarly, if there is a prices based on the tonnage, those can also be configured. So these are the different criteria, price criteria can be configured and system will accurately pick up those prices in the sales invoicing process, which helps for the accurate invoicing and reduces the customer complaints. Process and workflow configuration. Traditional WMS application, they offer a standard business processes. Any change to those standard processes is taken care normally using the customization in the standard processes, which adds extra timeline and cost to modify the standard process. Unlike traditional WMS application, 3PL Dynamics offers a configurable approach where change in any business process is easy to configure and which makes sure your system is capable enough to take care of any future change in business process or operations. Easy to configure WMS processes and workflows. Flexible to adopt future process changes without customization, lesser timeline and cost to and less cost to configure and implement new process changes. Scan view and status template, these are the powerful features of the 3PL Dynamics, which makes sure your system is ready for to adopt any future changes in the business process. Quick and easy way to configure various warehouse processes. For example, receipt, put away, shipments. For example, this is a app platform view. Let's say if, for example, in this view, I need to add in the screen another field in future to capture the certificate number for a specific customer or a specific customer item. To incorporate this change, I don't have to, there is no dependency to customize the whole process and write any programming language. 3PL Dynamics enables the user or authorized user to add the field and add the function, configurable function to achieve this change. This saves the time and cost to implement dynamic change in the business operations. Status templates defines various stages and statuses through which a warehouse process will go through. For example, an inbound process will go through new, confirm, in process, scan and completed. These are the various stages. Link business rules and process controls to various stages and statuses. So all these statuses can be linked to a specific business functions which can take care that warehouse employee or user is performing business process with the required process controls. For example, certain fields can be made mandatory or certain data from the trip needs to be copied to the receipt or shipment document. This makes sure the process has been controlled and there is no deviation. Integrations, Data Hub EDI integration platform. 3PL Dynamics works with Data Hub, which is its own EDI integration platform, and there is no dependency with any third-party EDI platform. Data Hub is based on the Microsoft Azure platform, always up to date, safe and transparent. It means a user can check the transaction of the EDI flows from the Data Hub. Cost-effective price model. Data Hub supports almost all types of EDI integration file formats, for example, X12, EDIFX, CSV, JSON, text format. File exchange protocols could be AS2, FTP, HTTPS, X400, SMTP, and API. Integration with warehouse control systems, WCS. 3PL Dynamics can also be integrated with the WCS warehouse control system to work with any automated warehouse. So it does have a capability to get integrated with the WCS and build those business operations in the 3PL Dynamics. Now let's quickly, I will switch over to the 3PL Dynamics. This is a home page when the user logs in into the 3PL Dynamics. So this is a view for office user. The landing page or role center is configured based on the role of the user. So let's say this is a 3PL order management view where a user can see a various received transaction, inbound transaction with the various statuses. User can also drill down and check the details of the transactions. Let's see a WMS contracts. So this is a contract configured for Victor Fresh Foods Limited. WMS contracts can be configured for various types of transaction, receipt, shipments, value-added logistic services, and transfers. It can also be configured for specific area or region. The prices can be defined or services can be defined according to that. Now for receipts, these are the various services are being configured for Victor Fresh Foods Limited. Storage charges, loading unloading charges, freezing charges based on the temperature range, and labeling. So labeling is an optional charge which can be defined here as optional. For storage cost calculation, there are various predefined methods available as per the industry standards which can be assigned in the customer contracts. Let's see the receipt transaction. This is a receipt document which gets generated either through EDI or Excel import, or office user can manually also create the receipt transaction. In the line section, these are the product details. And in the detail line section, these are the individual carrier or pallet details. Every document goes through a specific statuses in the 3PL Dynamics so that in the organization, everyone can track what is the current status of a particular document. Now let's see the view of the mobile app platform. I'm using web emulator at the moment, so this will be a similar view a warehouse user can see on his handle device. So if I go to number 4, receipt with advanced shipping notification, user either can enter the receipt or he can select from list of receipt. Scan the pallets. Now this view is completely configurable. We can hide or add any additional field over here, or we can also build a function to make the certain fields mandatory. Now in this case, user will enter the number of cases, weight of the pallet, temperature. confirm the receipt, scanning process. Now, if you see this, once users complete the scanning operation, system will post the detail lines in the receipts. So these are the two carriers been received here, and -4°C has been captured over here. Once complete receiving process is completed, status of this document is changed to scanned. If I change this manually here, once all scanning process is completed, warehouse user or office user will change the status of the document to the last status, and system will automatically add the contract lines for the invoicing. So system will automatically add services cost of receiving in the receiving transaction, and the prices will be picked up from the WMS contracts. During the invoicing period, system will pick up these all services, and invoice will be generated and will send to the customer. So that's how we have seen how 3PL Dynamics can help to optimize the cold store operation with the help of features which are specifically designed for cold store business operations. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions, please ask your queries. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Darshan. This question says, how does 3PL Dynamics offer a configurable approach? Could you elaborate a bit more on this? Thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Sure. So this is a app platform which warehouse user can see on the handle device. Now in 3PL Dynamics, scan view is a feature which controls the app platform screens. So in the scan view, I can add a specific field or I can hide a specific field. So we do have a complete or a person who is managing the system. He has a complete control of what should be the screen of the warehouse operations. Again, there is a functions which can be added to every actions in that page, which takes care that process controls are built throughout the operation. So using the scan view, this is completely configurable rather than customizing the standard process and modifying it. So this helps to implement any new changes within the time limit and with the less cost. Do we have any other questions?
Yep, there's another one here saying, does 3PL Dynamics have an inbuilt finance module?
Yes. As 3PL Dynamics is built on the D365 Business Central platform, it is seamlessly integrated with the finance module. So it offers the finance features like general ledger, perhaps. Yeah. It offers the general ledger, cash management, cost accounting, receivable, payable, fixed asset, inventory. So for receivables and payables, it's also very well integrated with all FMS, TMS, and WMS modules. Similarly, general ledger and fixed asset can be used parallel to that.
There's another one here. It says, can 3PL Dynamics be integrated with customers' system through EDI?
Yes, definitely. So 3PL Dynamics uses a data hub, its own EDI integration platform, and it's easy and convenient to integrate with the customers. So it supports, it's based on the Microsoft Azure platform, and it supports almost all the file formats for message, EDI message exchanging, X12, EDF FACT, CSV, SOP, JSON, etc. It also supports other protocols for file exchange, AS2, FTP, HTTPS, X400 SMTP and APIs.
Thank you, Darshan. There's another question here, and it's asking about how Business Central works seamlessly with 3PL Dynamics, about about the data transfer and how 3PL specific processes can be monitored easily and how it connects with Business Central. Could you tell us a bit more about that, please?
Yeah, sure. So 3PL Dynamics, it's 3PL specific vertical modules, which are FMS, TMS, WMS, and cold store. These are completely built on the Business Central platform. So integration with the finance is mainly AR and AP. For example, in WMS, TMS, and FMS, a sales invoices. So sales invoices are generated from these three vertical or four vertical modules and gets posted to the general ledgers or chart of accounts of the Business Central finance modules. Similarly, accounts payable side, the vendor master is a common master of the Business Central as well as these four verticals. So we are using the same master tables of the Business Central. And from these four verticals, a purchase invoices can be generated for the cost in case of, let's say, freight management. We are managing the multiple service suppliers. So their accounts, in the accounts payable, their invoices, bills can be booked, which again gets posted seamlessly to the general ledgers. Again, for the VAT posting groups, which is a standard feature of Business Central finance modules, which is being used, and same is applied during the accounts payable and accounts receivable modules. Similarly, fixed assets. So in warehouse operations or transport management, all your fixed asset can be registered in the finance module here, and their depreciation calculation and all can be done here.
Great, thank you, Darshan. There's another question here, and it's asking about cold storage challenges and any of the other features for 3PL Dynamics, which you might not have mentioned. If you could just briefly mention those and just explain a little bit about how these features can help tackle these cold storage challenges.
Yeah, for today's demonstration, we have mainly identified a put-away process here. The first is in the inbound process, like temperature recording. So if for the temperature recording, there could be a different scenarios. The companies follows the way the companies, they follow the process. So it helps to speed up the process as well as to it make sure that correct temperatures are recorded. And accordingly, system automatically adds the freezing charges in that transaction. So this completely eliminates human intervention or manual errors. System takes care of this kind of complex scenarios in invoicing process or adding the service charges automatically. So 3PL Dynamics does have that capability to configure the complex scenarios WMS contracts. Similarly, as we have seen, the put-away process. For example, these are the three scenarios we have considered for today's webinar session. One is the product has to go to blast freezer if every time or if the temperature range is not within the required range. The product specific temperature control zone, so specific product has to go to specific zones or any customer specific dedicated zones. There are a few other complex scenarios can be configured using the warehouse strategy feature of the 3PL Dynamics, like if there are moving racks, so we can also see how to system can identify which is a rack open. Always suggest the location from that open rack so that it will reduce the time to put away, and it will always, user will always go and put away the pallets to the open rack first. So these are the few examples, but there are more complex scenarios can be configured. Automatic replenishments during the picking process is one example there. So system automatically generates the replenishment activities from bulk to pick. So this way, system intelligently helps to optimize the warehouse operations.
That's great. Thanks very much, Darshan. There's another question here. It says, typically, how long does it take to complete one end-to-end implementation for a cold store WMS?
Yeah, so it typically takes 3 months if we go with the only WMS implementation. So within the 3 months, we end to end, we cover almost all the processes of the typical WMS implementation. Any other questions from the audience?
There's no other questions right now, so I think we can finish up here then. I don't see any others coming through.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you so much. Thanks for attending the webinar session.
Great, and thank you for your insight there, Darshan. And thank you everyone for attending. Please don't hesitate to reach out. So you can give us a call or you can email us. So the email addresses and the phone number are on the screen there.